morning to all the students of class 8. I hope you all are safe and healthy. Today we are going to start with the first online classes in physics, and the very first chapter is matter. I know most of you have already familiar with the word matter, but let us revise it again. Matter: anything that has mass and occupies space and whose presence can be perceived by our sense organ is called matter. Let us take an example of scale, water and air. We can say that scale, water and air all are matter. Now we are going to prove, I am going to prove that scale, water and air, they all are matter. Since we know that matter is being divided into three states, that is solid, liquid and gas. Let us take an example, the first example of solid, that is scale I have taken over here. Suppose if we are going to take a scale and we are going to place it on a table, what you will notice? Definitely it is going to occupy space. If it is occupying space, definitely it has mass. So it is proved that scale is a matter. Let us take another example, that is water. Take a glass of water. Approximately the volume of water is 1 liter. As you are going to pour a water inside a glass, what you will notice? It is going to occupy a space inside the glass. This shows that water is matter. And if it is occupying a space, definitely it has a volume. As I have told you already before, let the volume be 1 liter. Let us take another example, that is air. Since air is present everywhere, so if it is present everywhere, it is going to occupy space. And if it is occupying space, definitely it has some mass, that is atmospheric pressure. I hope all the three examples are clear to you. Now let us come to another topic, that is atom. The smallest unit of element, which may or may not have an independent existence but always take part in chemical reaction, is known as atom. Over here I have taken an example of chalk just to explain you what is matter. Just take a brick of chalk and try to break it into its smallest part. Well, the chalk is being broken into its smallest part and it cannot be broken further. That is called atom. I hope both the topics are clear to you. Let us come to another topic, that is elements. I hope everyone knows what are elements. So let us revise it again. Elements are the basic building blocks of all matter. It is defined as a substance which cannot be broken further or subdivided into two or more simpler substances by any physical or chemical process. Since we know that matter is made up of elements, now the question arises, what is an element? So let us take an example. Over here I have taken an example of building. Suppose I have to build a house or a building. So what I will need? It is obvious, the material that I use is brick, concrete or cement. Without these materials we cannot build a building. So over here, brick, concrete and cement, they are elements, and the material which is being used to build anything, that is building, is called matter. Let us come to another topic, that is molecules. The question arises, what are molecules? If a matter is made up of two or more different elements, then the smallest unit of matter is called molecule. Let us take an example, water. Since we know that water is made up of two molecules, I hope everyone knows, one atom of oxygen and two atom of hydrogen. So it is a combination of two molecules, then only we are going to form water. I hope this topic is clear to everyone. Let's come to another topic, that is movement of molecules. Since we know that if a matter is made up of two or more different elements, then the smallest unit of matter is called molecules. And we can say that molecules exist in free state in nature. Let us see an example. I have taken an example of water. Water, it can be written as H2O. Water is made up of two elements, that is one oxygen atom and two hydrogen atom. How they are bonded together? Some force is being attracting both the elements. If there is a force of attraction, definitely there will be a state of continuous motion. So molecules are in a state of continuous motion which cannot be seen through our naked eyes. We need microscope, and that state of continuous motion is called Brownian movement. I hope this topic is very much clear to everyone. Next time when we are going to meet, I am going to start with the second part of this chapter. Thank you and be safe.